Kjære publikum, velkommen i utgang. For at alle skal ha en god opplevelse, ber vi deg om å ta en pause fra mobiltelefonen under forestillingen. Vi minner om at det heller ikke er tillatt å filme eller ta bilder før i applausen. God fornøyelse. Dear audience, welcome to the Opera House. We kindly remind you that photography and video is not permitted until curtain fall. Enjoy the performance.
Kjære dronning Sonja, jury og publikum. Hjertelig velkommen til finalen I dronning Sonjas sangkonkurranse 2023. Jeg starter med et brak, så nå har vi liksom gjort det, og det greit. Dette en internasjonal konkurranse, og med oss på stream har vi et internasjonalt publikum. Så derfor vil jeg nå gå over til å snakke på engelsk. Welcome to the final concert of the 2023 Queen Sonja Singing Competition. It's a huge honor and pleasure to be presenting our finalists from 521 applications. 40 participants were invited to the preliminary rounds here in Oslo. 40 became 12 for the semi-finals, and tonight we have 6 wonderful finalists that will sing 2 arias each. 8 years ago, I was one of the finalists performing on this stage. I will never forget standing outside of the opera, crying before I was so nervous and I felt the pressure so intensely. However, it has been a fast speed train going forward ever since, apart from a certain pandemic. But I am so proud to have been a part of such a prestigious competition. Not only did I gain important exposure to an international jury, but I also got to know some of my colleagues that I also have contact with today. Additionally, I now know several members of the jury, both personally and professionally. It's safe to say that the competition has had a huge impact on my career. Last week, I did 2 concerts with our conductor for tonight, James Gaffigan. Given his successful international career, we are lucky to have him with us here this evening. He has had a lot of experience working with young singers, which makes him the perfect conductor for this concert. Together with the Norwegian National Opera Orchestra, I am sure this will be an evening to remember. And I know exactly how it is to be on this stage. Therefore, I have one job to you as an audience, and that is to give it your all. Please be supportive and welcome our finalists with a smile, and most importantly, give them a good round of applause. You can practice now. One. Yeah, that's for you. Exactly. Exactly like that, just a bit more, okay? I know you have more in you. But you need someone here to applaud for, that's why. Now, let's get going and let me introduce the 2 first singers for tonight. First out is Armenian baritone Navasar Hakobyan. Navasar is 25 years old and will be going into his 2nd season as part of the Young Artist Program at Houston Grand Opera. Navasar will dive straight into the opera drama with Enrico's aria Cruda Funesta Smania from Lucia di Lammermoor by Donizetti. Enrico, the Lord of Lammermoor, is very angry because he's discovered that his sister has betrayed him. She's been dating a man, and not just a regular man, but the man from a family that are sworn enemies. After that, we will continue with our one and only countertenor, the 29-year-old German Nils Wanderer. Nils has studied at the Hochschule für Musik Franz Liszt in Weimar, and in 2019, he was a part of the opera course at Guildhall School of Music and Drama in London. Nils will sing from George Benjamin's opera, Written on Skin, premiered in 2012. The boy, which is the name of the role, is a manuscript illustrator. And this aria is the key scene where the power dynamic, as well as the sexual dynamic, changes between him and the main female character in the opera, Agnes. But first, a big applause to Navasar Hakobyan.
сознанья. Дома звелят он петто, троппо, троппо рибле, questo fatal sospetto mi fa celare fremere, sollevo in fronte il crin, mi fa celare fremere, sollevo in fronte, sollevo in fronte il crin. Di tanto proprio chi suore a me accea apria che d'amor si perfida me svelar di re se ti colpisse un fulmine, se ti colpisse un fulmine, foramen rio, dolor, suo favore mi dissensi ma di detto se mi parli di vendetta solo intenderti potrò augurati il mio furore già su voi tremendo rogge io col sangue spegnerò, io col sangue, e mia fiamma che mi strugge in spegnerò, spegnerò, col sì, col sangue spegnerò, la mia fiamma strugge, io col sangue spegnerò, sì, col sangue spegnerò, la mia fiamma che vi strugge, l'empia fiamma che vi strugge, io col sangue spegnerò, sì, spegnerò.
as a boy, shows a house in
It's hard to clap and be excited at the same time. I'll do my job. Jasmine White is our next singer out. They are a 29-year-old contralto from America. And they are already going into the second year at the opera studio at Volksoper in Vienna. Jasmine will sing Juno's aria, Awake Saturnia, Iris Hence Away, from the opera Semele by Handel. Juno has just heard that her husband has taken Semele as his mistress and is keeping her in a palace guarded by dragons. She swears she will get revenge and decides to get help so that she can make the dragons fall asleep and then she can visit Semele herself. After that, we will hear the Ukrainian baritone Vladislav Tluch. Vladislav is 31 years old and has been a part of the Young Artist Program at the Opera House in Zurich and is now a member of the ensemble at the Opera House in Lucerne. Vladislav will sing from the opera I Puritani by Bellini. It's Riccardo that sings the aria A per sempre, who sings about the fact that the woman he loves and is supposed to be marrying, well, she loves someone else. But before we get into that drama, a warm welcome to Jasmine White.
tremble the universe this oath to hear. Not one of Costagena's race to spare. Hence, Iris, hence away. Iris, hence away. Scythian hills to the Miocene lake, a speedy flight will take. Hence, Iris, hence away, Iris, hence away, 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 a speedy flight will take, a speedy flight will take, a speedy flight will take, a speedy flight, a speedy
because
This is so much more fun to listen to than it was to be a part of, because then it was just nerves. Our next singer is the Swedish mezzo-soprano Rebecca Wallroth. Rebecca is our youngest singer tonight, only 23 years old, and next season she will be a part of the International Opera Studio at Staatsoper unter den Linden. Wallroth will sing Parto, parto, ma tu ben mio, from Mozart's opera La Clemenza di Tito, and it's the only duet this evening, and not with another singer, but with our wonderful clarinet player. It's like a little toast. And last but not least, we have Axel Dayevan. Axel is our second baritone from Armenia. He is 28 years old and is going into his last season at the Opera Zürich, where he is part of the Young Artist Program. Axel will sing Robert's aria Kto moshet sravnitsya from Tchaikovsky's final opera Iolanta. He is singing about how he doesn't want to marry Princess Iolanta because he has fallen madly in love with Countess Matilda. Ah. But first, Rebecca Wallroth and Parto, parto.
Oh, И жемчуг обряд,
счастью без мер, без конца и границ. Может сравниться с Матильдой моей, сверкающей искрами черных очей, как на небе звезды осенних ночей. Все страстною негой мне дивно полно, мне все опьяняет, мне все опьяняет. И жжет, как вино,
back in the day, people actually used to castrate male singers to keep their voices light.
The last one died in 992, meaning they can't be found across the world anymore.
Hopefully.
I've been thinking about this a lot recently because I think it's so unique to be in a line of work where you are able to explore something really profound and sincere and personal without it serving anything else than your own self. And I feel lucky. Well, preparing for a competition like this is a very lonely job, because you don't have a team around you like you normally do in opera productions, where you feel like you have collectively a sense of purpose. So it's hard standing by yourself in the studio practicing for something that's a very important platform to present yourself and to expose yourself with your work. I'm actually very excited about living here in Oslo and having my hometown as my base. At this point in my career, it's very important to stabilize my technique so that I in the future can take on bigger and more dramatic roles, because a big instrument like mine, like my voice is, takes a lot of time and it's a long process. Actually, I won't be in the height of my career before I'm in my 40s. With that perspective, I think it's also very important right now to just have fun and live my young adult life here in the city that I love.
While most of us sing at our natural frequency, opera singers actually sing at a different one to make their voices louder. This is why they don't have to use microphones.
What was it that made you fall in love with opera?
For me, it was this immediate kind of connection that you can build to the people. So we have all these stories and all these emotions that we can portray. That was really what drew me in, that I was able to stand on stage and tell a story. And the audience would immediately be able to react and feel it. Yeah.
So you said that this is one of your first big competitions at this level, and you just finished your preliminaries.
Yes.
What are you feeling right now? Have you taken a moment to realize where you are right now?
No, I mean, yes, it is one of the first international big one like this that I'm doing, and I'm just so happy to be here. And now that the preliminary is gone, it's like a huge relief. I think I'm happy with what I was able to show. I think I was able to show what I can do, which is all I can ask for, so I'm content.
And then, now that you have a feeling of Queen's Sonja singing competition, does it live up to the reputation? Is it everything you thought it
would be? Oh, it exceeds all the expectations of it, and definitely lives up to its reputation. I mean, the people here are fantastic. It's an extremely stacked field of competitors. All of these people are outstanding artists. No, it definitely lives up to everything I expected.
There is a play by Wagner that has killed not only one but two of its conductors due to technical challenges. The shortest opera of all time is known to be 4 minutes and 9 seconds. And the longest in 4.5 hours.
Ever wondered what the most expensive opera costume of all time was? Well, let me tell you, it was worth a whopping 15 million pounds.
Dear friends, I'm Lars Fleten, the executive director of the Queen Sonja Sing competition. I'm talking to you from the stunning opera house here in Oslo. 40 singers from 19 nations, we have now chosen 6 finalists to perform in the finals concert here in the opera house on this Saturday. Let us tune in and follow the power of the voice of the leading artist of the world today. And let us wish them the very, very best of luck. Please enjoy.
Our participants are the hottest opera talents in the world. We attract the best young singers of the world to apply for the competition and come to Oslo to compete for the prizes, of course, but not least to be exposed to the right people. If you take a look at the next season on the opera stages of the world, you will find a lot of former participants of the Queen's Sonja Singing Competition, and that's how we measure our success.
Congratulations to the finalists of the Queen's Sonja Singing Competition. I'm very excited that I will be back this year on Saturday because I will be presenting the finalists. I can remember very well how it was to be in the competition in 2015, so I'm sending you a lot of energy and good thoughts, and I look forward to meet you on Saturday. I think my best advice for the finalists is that you should trust yourself. There's a reason you are where you are now. That's because you've given it something extra, you've given it yourself, your personality. Keep doing that, and remember, it's a concert and the audience are there to support you.
Thank you. also had this halloumi wrap and I shared a salad with Hedvig. I
took a Belgian waffle with ice cream and I'm a big fan of ice cream.
I had something not too fancy, just a satay curry. Mm-hmm.
It was incredible. It was the best fried chicken I ever had in my life. Maybe that's sad, I don't know, but it was amazing.
I had half of it already, but Asian food is my comfort food. I love making it. I love eating it.
I like it. It's fresh. It gives me summer vibes.
I think Oslo is such a great city. Like, it's very clean, it's modern, it has like a really good vibe to it.
Crazy and shocking to be a finalist.
I'm so honored and so happy to be a finalist. It's a great pleasure.
I am sitting there in the semifinals waiting for my name to be called.
I mean, let's be honest, I knew that I good enough.
And this time, I really wasn't sure. And when it happened, I just kind of froze a bit. People were clapping.
I think I was shocked for one day before I realized that they chose me.
Me? Really? So I'm very excited and honored, of course. I mean, the competition was very heavy this year. Very, very skilled people from everywhere.
I'm also new that we'll be a lot of good singers.
To be chosen among such incredible talents.
It's a really fantastic moment and a new chapter in my life.
It's truly amazing to be competing with some of the best singers.
It's a big honor to be chosen by all of these fantastic singers, by this extraordinary jury.
It is wonderful to be a finalist in this prestigious competition.
It's such a huge honor that I've worked so hard to achieve.
It's a great joy and a big honor.
And I will try to do my best. I'm excited, I'm a little bit nervous.
I'm ready to deliver and just put on a great story. Saturday.
I can't wait to see that.
Thank you. What a celebration this is of the thing I love the most, opera. And thank you, audience. You've done a brilliant job. Now let's get ready for the second half, shall we? The second half of tonight's finale will start with some Wagner. Jasmine White will sing Erda's famous aria, Weiche Wotan, Weiche, from Das Rheingold. Erda, or Mother Earth, is coming to warn Wotan that terrible things will happen if he chooses the power of the ring. After that, we will hear Axel Dayavan, who will sing from Gounod's Faust, Avant de quitter ces lieux, and this is one of those arias where I am very grateful that someone back in the days stood up for themselves and said, hey, why isn't there anything for me? Because this was not originally in the opera, but because someone spoke up, we now have this beautiful aria about the soldier Valentin, who prays for his sister Marguerite's protection before he's sent out to fight in the war. But first, Weiche, Wotan, Weiche, with Jasmine White and our maestro, James Gaffigan.
Thank you.
singer have in the preliminary rounds and the semifinals presented songs as well as opera arias. And now we will hear our first and only song for this evening. Rebecca Wallroth will sing Flickan kom ifrån sin älsklingsmöte, and the song is written by Sibelius. And it's about a girl who's been meeting her lover, and every time she comes home, she must make up a story for her mother, so she doesn't suspect anything. But as it goes, it's not just kisses and holding hands, but also someone who's been very unfaithful. And from a very intense song about love, we will hear a more intense declaration of love. It's Yeletsky in the opera Queen of Spades by Tchaikovsky that sings the heartbreaking aria to Lisa about how much he loves her and how hard it is that she is not returning his love. I Love You, or Ja vas ljublu, will be sung by Navasard Hakobyan, but first, Rebecca Wallroth and Flickan kom ifrån sin älsklingsmöte.
Для вас вершить
You should all make it a mission in life to bring someone that hasn't been to the opera. Because, I mean, they all have to experience something like this. A concert, an opera, just this live music makes me so happy and so much more happy when I can listen to it rather than do it. That makes me very happy too, that's it. It sounds all wrong, but you know what I mean. It is. I love singing, that's true. Now we have actually reached our two last arias for tonight. And I think you're doing a great job. But yeah, keep it up. You know, there's jury, there's several people that will come here. You just do your job. We will hear some more Handel, and it's Nils Wanderer that will sing the aria Stille Amare, or the poison aria from Tolomeo, because Tolomeo believes himself to be betrayed and that he has been drinking poison. As we know, Handel arias often has a da capo or a repetition, but not this one, because unfortunately, Tolomeo has passed out before he reaches that part and can't sing it. But from an aria about drinking poison to Hamlet praising the power of wine, whilst making sure no one is suspicious about the fact that he knows exactly, or almost exactly, what happened to his father. On va dissipe la tristesse, or oh wine, dispel from this sadness, is from Hamlet by Thomas and will be sung by Vladislav Tlutsch. But first, Stille Amare and Nils Wanderer.
Gustare il piacere. La tristesse qui pèse sur mon cœur, à moi le remède l'ivresse et le rire est mon cœur. Ô liqueur, ô chanteresse, verse l'ivresse, l'oubli de mon cœur. Douce liqueur. Verse l'ivresse dans mon cœur, ô liqueur, chanteresse, verse l'ivresse, l'oubli dans mon cœur. Présage, le plaisage sans les faux. Ah, 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 ah. Va dissimuler la tristesse qui pèse sur mon cœur, à moi le remède l'ivresse. O liqueur, o chanteresse, verse l'ivresse, l'oubli de mon cœur. Douce liqueur, o liqueur.
Thank you.
This has been an absolutely amazing evening, and I must thank all the singers for their performance and hard work. I know we are here to announce a winner. That is how a competition goes. But I honestly think you are all winners. What we do is not about competing, it is about sharing stories through our art form. Competitions create a platform, an environment where singers can be seen and heard. 40 singers got that opportunity, and I think the experience and exposure will help all of them in their future careers. And now, to introduce this year's international jury, I would like to present the chair of the jury and the boss of the house, Randi Stene. This is so reversed, it's amazing. What has it been like to be a part of the jury and also the head of the jury?
Well, can you imagine how it's like to be head of this jury? This is such a distinguished jury, and they are not only extremely competent, but they are also really nice people.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah. Yeah. And that is true, they are really nice, and that's important to remember because we're so scared when we're on that side. But then they are also people. But I know that you have seen and heard a lot of talent, but in terms of what you're looking for, is it so that they all have to be stage ready, or how do you judge?
Yeah, it's a very good question, and I have to say also this has been really demanding for us to choose, especially tonight, to choose a winner. We do have a winner, but the level has been extremely even. And I think I can speak on behalf of the jury when I say that we are, of course, looking for the whole package. The voice, the technique, the willingness to give something, because that's what it's all about. That's what's most important here.
Yes.
That something speaks to you. So I think we are looking for everything, and we try to solve out this in between.
Yeah. Mm. And when you then try to solve out all of this, I know that you give votes, and they don't talk about it to each other. Of course, they can talk about how it is, but they don't share their votes. But can you explain how that works?
Yeah, it's exactly what you say. We are voting without knowing what the others are voting. So actually, when we have voted tonight, we didn't know who the winner was until it was counted up. And I think this is a good way of doing it because it's fair to all the contestants. And it also is a little bit demanding for us because we really have to be careful. It's all on each one of us. So I like this way of handling the jury work.
But is it like a Michelin star restaurant votes, or is it the dice 1 to 6? What's the sort of the number
well,
we're dealing
it,
with?
Well, it depends. It's a little bit different from the preliminary rounds and the semifinals, but today it was from 1 to 6.
Boom. Well, then I wish you all the best and
Thank
good
you.
Luck.
Thank you. And now it is my great pleasure to introduce you to this distinguished jury. And I will start with Michael Heason from the Metropolitan Opera in New York. Sophie de Lint from Dutch National Opera in Amsterdam. Stefan Harem, you know, but he is also coming from Theater an der Wien. Samuel Gelber from Washington National Opera in Washington, D.C. And we have Annette Weber from Open House Zürich. And we have Paul Christian Mo, who is working on various opera house as a casting consultant, amongst them Glyndebourne Festival Opera, and he's with me here in Oslo as well. Before we choose this year's winner, we have a special prize to award, and that is Ingrid Bjoner's scholarship. Ingrid Bjoner, she was running the opera in Oslo for years, but she, most of all, she was a world-famous soprano singer. And her foundation, in her name, has given the Queen Sonja Singing Competition the opportunity to award this prize to this year's best Norwegian participant. Congratulations to soprano Victoria Randem. Now I hope you will give Her Majesty the Queen a very warm welcome. And I hereby give you the secret envelope with this year's winners.
Thank you. It has been a wonderful evening, full of excitement, and especially for you, of course. And I must say a great, great thank you to all of you finalists, giving us such a wonderful evening, so exciting, so wonderful. So we have taken it all in. And also, thank you to the orchestra. You are a wonderful orchestra with your director, of course. And I would also like to mention the conferencier, Lisa Davidson. When I heard you were going to be a conferencier, I thought maybe you're going to sing that role. But you did not. But you introduced so beautifully, because you know everything in this field. So it's been a great joy to listen to you. Thank you very much, Lisa. And then to the most important part of this evening. Third prize goes to Nils Wanderer. Second prize goes to Axel Davian. And finally, of course, first prize, Jasmine White.
Congratulations, that's amazing. And Your Majesty, the jury, our finalists, and our audience, thank you so much for a wonderful evening. I would like to extend a big thank you to our great orchestra and conductor, James Gaffigan. Bravi! Additionally, I want to thank everyone who contributes to the organization and the operation of the competition. We should all feel proud that through this competition, Norway has a place on the international map of opera. To Her Majesty Queen Sonja, I want to say a warm and heartfelt thank you for your dedication and engagement to this competition and to our art form. Tusen, tusen takk. And now, we will, that's the best part, because we get to hear it again. Congratulations, Jasmine, and we will now hear Händel Semele, Awake Saturnia, Iris, Hence Away. Congratulations. And the rest of us, you can now start leaving.
Hence, hence, I across the lake. A speedy flight we will take. Hence away, away, a speedy flight, a speedy flight will take. I will his face molest, nor shall he sink again to pleasing rest, till to my vow revenge he grants supplies and seals with sleep. Oh, a speedy flight, a speedy flight.